Hello and thank you for joining me today. Today I'm sharing with you a mixed media canvas that I created featuring Relics and Artifacts Coronation Kit. This kit consists of four resin pieces and I absolutely fell in love with it. Anyhow, as you can see, I started with a little bit of plaster paste through a 13 Arts Stencil to give this canvas just a tiny bit of texture in the background. Now you can see that I'm adhering some chipboard with a little bit of tacky glue. And I probably should have covered this chipboard with gesso ahead of time, but I didn't because I really wasn't sure what I wanted to do at this point in time. So I just kind of went with it. So full disclosure, I'm going to probably ramble a little bit. This is sped up quite a bit just for the sake of time. So if you need to turn down the volume, please feel free. As always, try to give some credit where it's due. I'm not 100% sure who I saw do this, if it was Finnabair or someone from her team, but I know that the techniques that I used in this, especially with the rust paste later on, was someone from her team. And I'm sorry, I can't remember what video I saw, but if you see it, you'll know. I'm not trying to rip anybody off here. I hope they know that it is definitely a compliment that I use the technique. And it's even some things that I've probably picked up there here and there from different classes. Anyhow, I'm just trying to share my process and I hope that you appreciate that. If not, I am sorry. I'm not trying to offend anybody. Anyhow, I digress. I'm just going to continue to play with my configuration, tucking in some paper roses, just trying to stabilize that crown. Once I had everything in place, I went ahead and put some gesso on those chipboard pieces, but I left my metallic pieces because I wanted to play with some rust paste later, and you'll see that. Here you can see that I'm just adding some color using some Lindys spray and some water, and I'm just using the water to soften the color quite a bit. I think that I picked this up probably mostly from Tiffany, and I'm not sure how to say her last name, but y'all know who she is, I'm sure. Anyhow, so I'm going to dry this puddle of water that's on my canvas, and you'll see me do that quite often. I do try to cut a lot of that out of the video so it doesn't run on forever. Now I'm just picking up a little bit off my mat and coloring my roses and darkening a couple places here and there with a paintbrush. Just where I think needs a little bit more color. So I'm still just trying to play with it and figure out where I want to go. Here, I'm just adding a tiny bit of heavy bodied gesso to highlight some of the pieces that I'm going to use rust paste on and that I'm going to use wax on in the future. Now I'm going to add some rust paste. And I'm just using a tiny, tiny little bit. I don't want this to take over the canvas. I just kind of want to get a little bit of a vintage feel, maybe a worn, tattered look. So I'm just adding in a little bit around the mechanical pieces that I've used. And you can see that I'm just using the tiniest little bit of paste and then I'm spraying it with water so it'll move around and make a kind of like a flowy, natural look. At least that's how it looks to me. So I'm going to continue that around the metallic pieces and in the creases where the heart is. I'm just going to keep working with it until I'm happy. When in doubt, use water, right? So after everything is dry, and it does take a while, and I cut that completely out because no one needs to see me using a heat tool. But please make sure that it's dry. Anyhow, now I'm just adding in some art stones on top of the rust just to kind of give it more of a grungy, more depth feel. So I'm just using a little bit of just glossy gel, I think. And I'm just mixing some art stones in, some regular art stones, and some mini art stones. And you'll see me add those in. There they are. I do this on both sides, focusing primarily on just the resin pieces. And I'm just kind of trying to build up that rusty look. You just see me continue to work with the art stones. Sorry, I didn't want to chop this up too much. It was already so jumpy and sped up so fast, and I just hate for these videos to be that long. I'm not recreating the wheel here, and these are all processes that you've seen before. I'm just trying to share how this canvas came together. And anyhow, you know what I mean. So now I'm going to go back and start coloring my resin pieces. Now, if I had known what I was doing in the first place, I could have done this before I adhered it to the canvas, but I didn't really know what I wanted to do. So now you'll see that I'm using Finnabair's brass paste, and this is out of the patina set, I'm pretty sure. But I'm going to use a whole mix of paints, and a lot of the paints are, you know, mixed with three different colors. But everything that I do use, I will list in the description box below. So you can hunt and peck there. If you have any questions, please feel free to list them and I will absolutely get back to you. And then I'm using some Lindys squirts here. And now I haven't used these before, so I really wasn't sure how much I was gonna need. And obviously that was way too much. But I do love the color and the shimmer is gorgeous. So I'm gonna have to work with those because I haven't played with them very much lately. Actually at all. So I'm going to see how that goes. But I'm just mixing a little bit of the paint to kind of get the crown to be a different color than the base of that flame. I just wanted it to stand out a little bit, but not too much, if that makes any sense. And with that napkin, I was just kind of covering the art stones so they wouldn't blow away on me. This one is another squirts from Lindsay's Stamp Gang. And I didn't want to do the flame and all that. I just wanted to have a little bit of red, so I used that and some Sparks paint, and then I mixed in some more of that metallic paint that I used on the crown and on the base. So it's just a whole mix, and I'm just trying to get that to look like a flame, but still be metallic, but still be different, like three different colors. But it's all very subtle in the end. And of course, you know, I had to touch my canvas because I'm a slob when I create, obviously. So I just fixed that later. You'll see, maybe, or maybe I deleted it. I just put a little bit of gesso over it and some of the spots on the canvas that I wanted to lighten up a little bit. You know, gesso goes a long way to fix messy people like me. So I just didn't worry about it and went back to it later. Now with the heart, I really couldn't get it the color that I wanted. So first I tried some squirts, and then I tried some liquid acrylic, and I didn't like that. And then I went in for some metallic acrylic, and I think the combination of the three I was pretty happy with. I did do a second coat of this off camera after I let it dry, and you'll see it's a really, really deep red. Here you can see I'm just trying to get the stroke marks out, because I am so horrible to my paintbrushes. They are in such poor, pitiful shape. I don't know why I abuse them so. Anyhow, I'm just mixing in some more paint to the flame just to try to get it to look, I don't know, like a flame, just to give it some movement. Now I'm adding some clear crackle glaze to this heart. And this is from Deco Art. I just let it dry naturally. It dries super fast. And I actually really, really like this product. I put a pretty heavy coat on and got some pretty decent crackles, but I do cover it up, but it adds the whole effect. So you can see a little bit of that in the close-ups. Here's the gesso so I can fix my mistake. See, there you go. And I do that a couple more times and it's gone. Now I need to go in and make all those art stones look like rust. So I'm going to add some more rust paste and some water, and you'll see me repeat the process that I did earlier. A little bit of rust paste, tiny bit, right on the art stones. You can see I'm just moving that around, and then I'll spray it with water. And that's just so it looks more natural and it moves a little bit better. Doesn't look so harsh. trying to move my canvas around. Sorry, I know that gets out of focus, but it's really the only way for me to see all the nooks and crannies to make sure that everything's covered. And I'm just moving the water and then dabbing with a paper towel to make sure that it doesn't go too far. I want it to bleed out naturally, but not take over the canvas, if that makes any sense. So now I'm adding a little bit of liquid acrylic, and I'm adding water, and you'll see that it just dabs down. I used true yellow here and burnt sienna, and I'm just trying to add some depth to the rust so it isn't just orange. So I'm just kind of playing with the colors here until I get it the way I want it. And you can see that is the tiniest, tiniest amount of paint, and it really does go a long, long way. And you can see those colors bleed out and mix in with the greens and the blues. It's really pretty. So I'm just playing with it here and there and moving it. I'm sorry if it's giving you a little bit of motion sickness. But there really wasn't any way to just have it be flat. So I'm just playing with the liquid acrylic still. Adding water, dabbing, and drying. It's kind of a tedious process, but it's so satisfying to see that color move. I can't explain it. You just gotta play with it. You'll love it. And there's the dry time. Make sure you dry with this, because you will not believe where water will hide. So now I decided that I want to add a star to my heart. Like I said, not really sure where I wanted to go with this. A little bit of gel, removed it, and now I'm adding some gesso. I'm highlighting this because I'm going to cover it with rust paste. As you can see, and I just wanted to pick up the color a little bit better. And then I'll add some acrylic paint just like I did around the canvas. So really I just made sure that all my metallic pieces had a little bit more rust, I guess was the theme with this canvas. There you can kind of see the play on color a little bit better. And the burnt sienna to give some more depth. And I'm just going to keep playing with it. You know, paintbrush in one hand, heat tool in the other, water. And then, you know, there's no rhyme or reason. There's no great secret. It's just playing with it until you're happy with it, till you find something that looks good. And if it doesn't look good, cover it up with gesso and start again. If you make a mistake, cover it up with gesso and start again. If it's too dark, use a little bit of gesso and highlight it like I'm doing here. And just keep playing with it. There's no limit to how many layers you can put on this. You can see I'm just highlighting things that I thought were too dark with gesso. So I can come back and add highlights with wax here. And I don't want the wax to take it over, so I'm using this tiny little brush. So I'm just adding some wax around the canvas. I'm trying to pick up and accent that chipboard so it doesn't get lost, and some of the details from the stencil with the wax here. I don't want them to be the focal point, but I do want them to stand out just a little bit more. And I found that if I use this bristle brush instead of my finger, I don't go crazy with the wax. It keeps it really light. But as you see, I keep wanting to add wax, so I have to stop myself sometimes. Sorry for my reach there. I'm wearing my dad's old shirt, so it's beaten up and huge. Now I'm just adding a little bit of highlight with some of the metallic paint that I used on the crown. And that's just to accent the flowers so they look more like part of the canvas and not just extra things added on top. Just trying to make it more cohesive. And I added a rusty little butterfly. I think that's a Finnabair mechanical as well. And I'm going to add this sticker quote from 7 Dot Studio that I just placed on a bit of chipboard so it would be stable and not be bendy. Okay, and it says Gypsy at heart. I thought that fit this canvas pretty well. Fits me pretty well. And now I'm going back in and adding some more wax because, hey, why not? Just wanted all the detail in this set to really pop and shine. It's such a beautiful little kit. I love these four pieces. They go together perfectly, and there's so many different things that you could do with them. Anyhow, I just wanted to add a couple little sparkles into the crown to give it those little, kind of like make them little gems. So a little bit of Stickles, and then I added that to the flame as well. And that was it. There's my canvas. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for spending your time and watching with me. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them, and I appreciate them, and I will try to get back to you as soon as possible. If you haven't subscribed, I hope you'll consider. And that's it. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.